Welcome! I'm Chrissy and this is my channel Chrissy Love, where I review perfumes. And today I am talking about the 5 tea scents in my collection. Thank you for being here. Thank you for liking and subscribing and just generally being part of this perfume community with me. So if you like tea scents, this is the day for you. Let's jump in. So 3 of my 5 tea scents are actually in mini size because truth be told, I'm not actually that into tea scents. It's hard for me to find them that satisfy me because I really am a gourmand lover, and tea scents can oftentimes be too fresh. But these are the ones that I have, so I thought I would talk about them. The first one I have here is Elizabeth Arden White Tea, the Eau de Toilette, and I have a little mini size here. Now for this, the top notes are sea notes, fern, mandarin orange, and clary sage. The middle notes are white tea, white iris, and mate, and the base notes are ambrette, exotic woods, tonka bean, and amber. And when I spray this, what I really get is a very crisp, dry tea scent. It's slightly floral, but it's very fresh, and it actually has a slightly synthetic tea note. Like, it doesn't quite smell like tea leaves. It smells like almost an interpretation of tea. And there's absolutely no sweetness. It's not complex. It's like a very straightforward, very crisp scent. And in the dry down, it's actually quite harsh. So I guess this is kind of like not so much a review as me saying I don't really love this scent. but it's very crisp. It smells more like a laundry starch than a tea. It is so crisp, so fresh. It's hardly a tea. It really just smells like something you would use to starch your laundry. So if you like fresh, this is as fresh as it gets. This is like laundry clean, fresh. And if you like that, I think that's awesome. This definitely fits the bill. It's a little too fresh for me. There isn't quite enough sweetness, but would I love smelling this on somebody else? Yes, I think it is sophisticated just because it's so clean and so fresh that you kind of can't have an issue with it. Performance is pretty good. It lasts throughout the day. The projection lasts for the first few hours you're wearing it. And it stays really crisp the whole time on my skin. It doesn't dry down into anything else that's more complex than that. So really what you see is what you get. But yeah, this is a really nice freshy, if that's what you're looking for. I wouldn't say it speaks too much to my experience of drinking tea, but it has that freshness that I might expect from a crisp white tea. So that is Elizabeth Arden White Tea, the Eau de Toilette. So after smelling the original white tea, I thought, well, the vanilla orchid version might be more up my alley because I wanted something fresh, but I wanted some sweetness. So I have here Elizabeth Arden White Tea Vanilla Orchid, and this is an Eau de Toilette as well. Now the top notes are quince, bergamot, elemi, I don't know what that is, E-L-E-M-I, and lemon. Middle notes are vanilla orchid, white tea, gardenia, and jasmine, and base notes are vanilla, musk, orris, amberwood, and ambrette. Now this smells almost like a citrusy scent to me, which makes sense with the bergamot and the lemon and the quince. It's very zesty, but it is still dry. It's interesting. It's not like a juicy zesty. It's like a dry, like lemon zest that has kind of been sitting around for a while. It's not juicy and fresh. There is pretty much no sweetness in this, which I was very sad about. But then in a deep dry down, the vanilla comes out a little bit more. It's still quite crisp, just like the original, but the vanilla does sweeten it up on my skin. It pulls out a little bit more. And the vanilla I get is kind of like a syrupy vanilla. So it's actually a kind of sweet caramelized kind of vanilla. But what's really odd about this perfume is that the sweet vanilla doesn't quite mesh with the other notes, like the citrus and the actual tea smell. It kind of just like sits apart. So it's not well blended and it kind of feels disjointed. Like the notes don't quite fit together. Like you kind of get the syrupy vanilla, but on top of that, you're getting this like pungent, crisp, fresh linen experience with citrus. It should work, but it just doesn't for me. The performance is slightly weaker as well. It only lasts for a few hours on my skin and then it's pretty much gone. So this was a really odd one for me. I thought that I'd really love this, but it does not fit the bill for me. But I would say it leans more floral. So if you do like florals in your crisp, freshly ironed linens, then you might actually really enjoy this because it is quite fresh still. It does, the vanilla on my skin pulls out a little bit more, but like on clothes, it doesn't. It's still quite crisp and fresh. So yeah, that is Elizabeth Arden White Tea Vanilla Orchid, the Eau de Toilette. The next one I have here is Guerlain's Aqua Allegoria line, and it's Tea Zora. I have a little sample size. Now the top notes are lemon, bergamot, yuzu, and grapefruit. Middle notes are green tea, chamomile, and jasmine. And the base notes are cologne, C-A-L-O-N-E, cologne, vanilla, and musk. And this to me is actually the most realistic tea scent of all of them. Like, it really smells like unsweetened oolong tea. And you know, oolong is kind of like a well-rounded, it has like a natural sweetness to the tea leaves. It's probably my favorite tea leaf if I was to have just like a single one without flavor and stuff in it, like I always do, of course. But it has a really authentic tea character, like you're really smelling the leaves brewing in water, which is so beautiful, with this little hint of citrus. And in the deep dry down, it's just like tea leaves steeping. Like, it is exactly the experience to me of tea leaves steeping. There's some sweetness. It's also kind of mellow and calming. There isn't anything too crisp about it. There isn't anything pungent about it. It's relaxing. That chamomile is really nice in there. The vanilla brings a little bit of sweetness. So this is a really pretty one that I actually really enjoy, that to me conjures up actual memories of like sitting in a tea house. We have a really pretty tea house here where you can kind of just sit for hours if you want and order all kinds of exotic teas. And this kind of brings me back to that experience. So in terms of performance, it's pretty decent. It lasts most of the day, but it's not a super strong scent in itself. It's kind of mellow. So I wouldn't say it jumps off your skin. It really pretty much stays close to you, but it does last. And I will say, after wearing this for like a whole day, it really did lose the sweetness that it had had in the dry down earlier. But that's okay. If you just reapply it, it pretty much comes back, that little bit of sweetness. But just so you know, after the end of the day, you're going to be stuck, or not stuck, but you're going to have a nice mellow tea scent with some citrus and not much sweetness. So yeah, this was actually a pretty nice one. So that is Guerlain's Aqua Allegoria Tea Zora. So this next one really does fresh tea right, in my opinion. And this is the Maison Martin Margiela Tea Escape from the Replica line. So the Replica line is all about recreating experiences that you might have had that are commonly had. And so this, I think, doesn't actually recreate the experience for me, just because it isn't like the type of tea that I usually drink, but it's still really lovely. So the top notes are mint, bergamot, and pink pepper. The middle notes are green tea, jasmine, and osmanthus. And the base notes are milk, rice, and mate. And when I first put this on my skin, I get dandelion wine. That's what I get. I don't know if you ever had dandelion wine, but it's a really bitter wine, and it is floral, but it doesn't taste nasty. It tastes good, but it's kind of like a more bitter, dry wine. And it's very crisp. And like that, I get this like realistic leaf smell, like a tea-like mellowness. Not like the white tea, like a mellow realistic tea. And in the dry down, I'm still getting like what I interpret as like a dandelion smell. Now it might be the jasmine, and they do smell different, but it's definitely a floral smell to it with a kind of sweetened black tea kind of scent to it, even though the green tea is the key tea in this one, as well as mate. I get kind of a black tea vibe. I get some bitterness, but still very mellow, very realistic, not too pungent. The performance, though, is where it lets me down, because it really doesn't last long at all. It's like a couple of hours and it's gone. And then the deep dry down, I'm left with like no sweetness, but you know, still a basic tea experience, not much citrus. I do think the milk and the rice notes and the base notes do round this out and serve to make it really mellow. So if you want like a relaxing tea experience that isn't really a freshy, but is more like a realistic mellow tea, then I think this is actually a pretty realistic interpretation. So yeah, not bad. Not my favorite, but not bad. So this is Maison Martin Margiela Replica Tea Escape. This final one is the one that's really up my alley when it comes to tea scents, because it's very sweet. And actually, tea is not a note in this, but it makes me feel like it has tea in it. So that's why it's an honorable mention, I guess. So it's Tokyo Milk's Honey and the Moon. That's the bottle there. Now the notes are honey, sandalwood, sugar, violet, and jasmine. And what I get from it is a black tea sweetened with honey, like a lot of honey. It's very sweet, but also is a very realistic tea smell, which is funny because tea isn't actually in the notes, but that's what it really feels like. It feels like a black tea. And in the dry down, the sandalwood does kind of come out more. It becomes a little more earthy and woody, and it does round out the base, but it still has this realistic black tea with honey scent to me. I'm not getting any of the florals. That's not coming out for me. And it does not develop much over time. This really stays to me like black tea with honey on my skin. And in terms of performance, it stays on my skin all day. It has really great staying power. And then the projection is pretty good as well. I can kind of smell it wafting around me throughout the day. So this is a really nice one. And when I'm craving something really calming and but sweet, this is a really nice one because it just brings me back to like a good old overly sweetened calming when you're a kid, you know, when you're sick and you just need something to make you feel better, like a nice tea scent for me at least. So again, that is Tokyo Milk, Honey and the Moon. Those were the tea scents and tea inspired scents in my collection. Let me know what tea scents you really enjoy. And if you know of any that particularly have a sweet lean to them, that'd be of extra interest to me. So thank you for being here, and I hope you have a very beautiful day.